welcome back to Hike Oregon. It's a little chilly. Yeah. We are here at the Twins parking lot again with Tabitha. This is funny because the last time we hiked together, we were at the same trailhead, but going to Waldo Lake. So today we are actually heading up to the Twins. It's about 3.3 miles or so to the top. And we're hoping the clouds clear up a little so that we can get a great view from the top there and maybe have a little sun come out because it's quite chilly. It's in the 30s, so. But we are at like 6,000 feet, so it makes sense that it's cold. It's great fun, and I will catch you on the trail. My eyes are watering. One of the last thru-hikers of the season. There they go, PCT. This is where I left the cooler, if you recall, last time we were here. I will link that video below. Yeah, so we're heading up this way, so that's PCT southbound, and then PCT northbound, and we are heading up Twins Trail Summit. So I was about to take a picture of that sign down there at the trail junction and my camera wouldn't, like the button wouldn't press down. I'm like, what the hell? Sure enough, no SD card. What the heck? Never done that before. Such an amateur mistake. And I usually have extra SD cards in my backpack, but I took them out for when I went backpacking just in case I needed another one, and I never put it back. That sucks because it's a view hike and the camera is obviously better than the phone. Super frustrating, but lesson learned. Always check your stuff, and the SD card from this camera does not fit in there because it's the micro SD. Super lame, super lame. We came across a little pond here. This is so cute. It totally looks like a drinking hole.
Yeah.
For animals. Let's see if there's tracks. Is this a cat or a dog? That looks cat-like to me. What do you guys think, cat? Cat? That looks like cat.
Hmm.
Doesn't it?
Yeah, in a way, it does.
It's very round.
Yeah, that's what I was going to say. It's not pointy.
There's a mountain bike. There's deer.
We saw a horse.
What do you think?
Yeah, look how round that is.
That looks like cat to me. Well, This is where Kitty comes to drink. It's super pretty with the tree reflections.
Yeah.
I love that. We are here at our next trail split, Twin Summit Trail up there. Now if you're doing the long loop, you can come this way. There's also another way from the Charlton Lake Loop that goes up, but you can also come this way and then go up. But yeah, so pretty. Now we're headed up. I think it's in just another half mile or so. There's some old tracks of some sort. Snow. Hopefully not too much more as we go up. Okay, we're heading up. It is steep. You can tell, you can see how steep that is.
I'm dying.
Whew. There's some snow. We're hungry, ready for lunch, ready to be at the top. Wow, that view is cool.
So nice.
With all those clouds. Wish I could take a picture. Okay, so I'm gonna zoom in on Bobby Lake. Woo! I don't know if you could, that's hard to see because of the mist, but that rock that you see is that rock outcropping that we swam at. Yeah, so pretty. And that is Maiden Peak. Oh, it's cold. Oh, it's cold up here. 7,800 feet. So neat. Wow. 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 I feel like you're on top of the world. Whew. Crescent Lake. Wikiup Plains, Wikiup Charlton Butte, Charlton Lake. This is amazing. Beautiful. And then we have Waldo Lake over there too. Okay, so it's called the twins because this is one twin, and that's the second twin. Anyway, it's really cold up here, so we're going down. Woo, windy. Wow. I wonder what the temperature is. We were up there at the perfect time because, as you can see, well, you can't see now, but that's where we were up there. Totally socked in, just happened. Like 5 minutes. Within 5 minutes, totally socked in. Oh, this is so pretty. I love the way that looks.
Mine's your Christmas.
That is so gorgeous. Okay guys, we're back at the car. We hiked 6.75 miles and gained 1,700 feet elevation. And that was all on the way up. So in like 3.5 miles, we gained 1,700 feet, which is pretty decent. I mean, it was pretty steep. This is a great, great, great hike. I highly recommend it for anybody. It's really close to Eugene. Only takes like less than an hour and a half to get here, which I think it's pretty close for a cool hike like this. It also has the blue diamonds on the trees, which makes it accessible for winter, So if you're cross-country skiing or snowshoeing, you can come up here and do it on this trail, because the trail is marked all with blue diamonds. So, yeah, it's a great option for winter, too. And 6.75 miles for snowshoeing is, like, a longer hike for snowshoeing. Well, and the fact that it's steep and strenuous, yeah. If you're just going flat and snowshoeing, you know, 10 miles, probably not an issue. But I would say it's the perfect day excursion for snowshoeing, especially first or second timer. Probably don't want to do more than 7 miles. So I've gone quite a few times, and the last time I did 8 miles or so, I was just wiped out. Snowshoeing is strenuous. So anyway, I hope you enjoyed coming along, and I will catch you on the next adventure. Okay, bye.